again, everybody, and welcome to Big Time Wrestling right here on KOFY TV 20. Hank Renner Jr. along with Dragon Dave, sponsored by SharpshooterFunding.com. And we have a debut tonight, Dave.
Hey, I had fun. Salinas. I'm telling you right now, that crowd of Salinas, they love their wrestling.
Fantastic.
And they showed it, too. They showed up and they showed us their support. I'm telling you right now, I can't wait to go back.
There's a few things. I don't know if they want you back, but folks, thank you so much. It was a great time. Salinas is a great, great town with wrestling history. It's been a long time since we've seen wrestling at Salinas. The Police Athletic League Armory, what a beautiful building that is. Lovely people in Salinas. Thank you so much.
Yeah. You know, for a minute, I thought I was in rodeo season when I went there. But, you know, but
there
that's,
we go. I knew it.
But that's beside the point.
I knew it. Ten seconds in, and he's already started.
Hey, you know, I thought I would have to bring my, lasso and, you know. But then again, that's another story.
Is there anyone else you haven't insulted tonight?
No. It was a great crowd. And let me tell you something. The match itself, a rematch.
It is indeed. Zach Muir, the Zen Master. To everybody out there in TV land, take a deep breath with me. Doesn't that feel better, Dragon Day?
And those relaxation exercises are doing him good. Because why? He won against Andre LeBeau. He's one up on Andre LeBeau. Now, here's a rematch. And let me tell you something. Those Zen exercises, they're working.
We've got the exercise against the beads. And I'll tell you, Andre LeBeau, great new young competitor. He's my pick tonight, Dragon Dave.
Who?
Andre LeBeau.
Oh, yes, the party man. The party man. But let me tell you something. You know, Party time.
Well, you're not at any clubs with Justin Bieber look-alike over there. Folks, coming up right now, right here on Big Time Wrestling.
Party.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. This match has a 15-minute time limit. Referee for your contest, Alex Goldstein.
Hello.
One, two. Here you go.
Introducing first, making his way to the ring from Eureka, California, weighing in at a heavy and so light, and his mind is quite heavy. He is Zen Zach.
You been waiting for, I mean the game was all bad just a week ago. Rappers was bullshit, listen I ain't hating no cause now I'm getting.
And his opponent making his way to the ring from New Orleans, Louisiana, weighing in at 220 pounds, Andre LeBeau.
That mean my tables turn. Live life, might as well. Only way to learn is try and fail. Clientele, the only way to earn. So if you're selling or if you're selling rap, make sure it's mean so the fiends keep on selling back. Who that? That got that flame. Who that? That got that flame.
Everybody, welcome to Big Time Wrestling right here, KOFY TV 20. I'm your host, Hank Renner Jr., along with the bead-wearing Dragon Dave tonight. We've got Andre LeBeau all the way from New Orleans and Zach Muir.
Yes, I just want to let you know Andre LeBeau gave me these beads, you know, before the show, so I'm feeling very festive, and I see you're quite naked without beads, you know, but, hey, you know, hey, you can't win them all. You know, hey, you know, I got the beads,
but
you know.
But
I got to tell you something. But, you know, special favors, special requests, you know, I mean, I'm telling you right now.
Hold on a second, Dave.
Wait a minute. Whoa, way up.
Look at these now.
Wait a minute.
There we go.
And yours is gold.
Yeah.
Well, what?
They certainly are.
What? These
cost a fortune.
These cheap beads? I'm telling you right now. Well, who needs this?
Well, you should pay up next time. Zach Mira, the Zen master. Andre Laveau with the headband all the way from New Orleans. Party in the ring. No problem, he says. We talked to Andre Laveau earlier, and we got his comments, and he said, no problem. I got it well in hand. Not that he's underestimating Zach Mira, because Zach Mira is a force to be reckoned with here in big time wrestling.
And he's dangerous with his feet. I'm talking about karate, you're talking about taekwondo, jiu-jitsu, judo, and all that stuff.
All of the martial arts, he
yes.
definitely is. And folks, we're sponsored by sharpshooterfunding.com
yes.
right here on KOFY TV 20. Welcome aboard, everybody, to a big lockup right in the center of the ring. Zach Mira, Andre Laveau goes for that inside arm cradle. He's got it, no problem, Dragon Dave, no problem.
I got to tell you something, Zach Mira must be giving away, I don't know, 50 pounds maybe, something
yeah,
to that
there.
Extent,
yeah,
I'm
yeah.
telling you.
Uh-oh.
But you know.
That's one way when you can't wrestle your way out of a hold that has been put on you, you go ahead and stomp on the feet. And that's some beautiful footwork there shown by Zen Zach Mira. Everybody at home, take a deep breath
yes.
now. There
yes.
we go. There's a shoot-off.
Hold on.
Charged by Andre Laveau. And down and out goes Zach Mira. Holy Toledo.
Well, this is just the start off of the match, but you're going to be seeing a lot of footwork on the part of Zach Mira.
Oh, no.
Wait a minute. What's going on here?
Andre Laveau was having a Zen moment. Oh, my goodness.
Has he been taking some Zen classes? I don't know. I mean,
he might. I know you have.
Yes, and I feel relaxed.
Do you?
Yes, very relaxed.
Why don't you take a nap? Because,
leave you here by yourself?
Well, you know, that's
you'll
fine.
Ruin the show.
Ruin the show with
yes,
you.
I'm telling
just
you.
Imagine what I do to it by myself. We'd lose sharpshooter funding. We don't want to do that. Here we go. There's a go behind by Zach Mira and now into a headlock. And he's, oh, look at this. He says, quiet.
No, what he's doing is he's taking Andre Laveau to the floor, you know, cutting off his legs, basically. And you know, once you have,
style,
yes, once
yeah.
you have it on the floor, you know, that's half the battle right there.
It certainly is. In big time wrestling, the way to win a match, you cut the ring in half, cut your man in half. Now, what is this? Zach Mira didn't look what he's doing.
Well,
got distracted by the crowd. Beautiful high elevation arm drag. Andre Laveau looking great. In control here.
That's one thing that Zach Mira needs to work on is, you know, he doesn't concentrate on the match, you know, completely. He's always distracted by the fans.
Distracts himself by the fans, Dragon Dave.
I keep telling him. I keep advising.
Oh, look at this.
I keep advising him.
Oh, look at that. Handful of headband blinds Andre Laveau and comes in with a knee in the breadbasket. And look at Mira blaming the referee. Beautiful spinning kick finds its marks. And now Andre Laveau is in deep, deep trouble.
Well, that's why he went to the corner. Look at him. He's in the corner. And the referee right then and there should be, you know, cutting off this, he's cutting off Zach Mira because Andre Laveau is on the ropes.
Beautiful reverse of the whip. High elevation arm drag. Andre Laveau in command.
Now on the offensive, Andre Laveau. And that's how back and forth a match can go. 1 minute you're on top, the next minute, you know, you're in trouble. You never know. You got to be able to just concentrate on the match and control the match as much as you
Listen
can.
Listen to this crowd here at Salinas at the Police Athletic League Center, a beautiful historic building in downtown Salinas. And Andre Laveau is turning it around. Oh, and there's one for Zach Mira.
Wow, looks like Andre Laveau has been taking some karate classes too.
He certainly has. He looks great tonight.
I'm telling you.
One for that 10 count. Oh, got up to three. Oh, you got to watch that with Zach Mira. Oh, boy.
Uh-oh.
This mirror.
Belly to belly.
Belly suplex.
Yes.
Oh, man. That'll knock the wind out of your sails in a hurry.
I'm telling you right now, this could be it right here. No.
Two only.
Yes.
That's youth and conditioning.
Well.
Youth and conditioning right there.
Zach Mira, just letting Andre Laveau have it with those kicks, you know.
That one found the mark.
Well.
A little high for my
taste. No, inner thigh, it's legal.
In your book, maybe.
Yes, it's completely
legal.
Well,
we're going to have to let referee Alex Goldstein look at, and a half crab now, but it's around the ankle. That is very, very punishing, folks. Look at how bent in Andre Laveau's left ankle is.
Yes.
And those are regulation boots. That's why these wrestlers wear high boots like that, to protect the ankle from a situation just like this. But even then, you're still in a world of hurt, and Zach Mira is just putting it on Andre Laveau.
And all this time, I thought it was a fashion statement. Those high boots. That's all all this time. I thought about that.
You know, you never cease to amaze me. 53 weeks we've been on TV together, and 13 years.
Oh,
there's a handful of hair.
What happened?
That'll. What do you mean? What happened? What are you not looking at the same match I am?
Oh, I saw that.
Yeah, I bet you did.
Yeah, I saw that one.
Andre Laveau felt that one, and I think all the crowd here in Salinas and up in the Bay Area felt that one.
Look at Zach Mueller just measuring. Measuring Andre Laveau.
That's called an axe kick.
And it found its mark.
Yes, it certainly did. An axe kick that uses the back of the heel, which is a very, very potent weapon to use against Andre Laveau and any of your opponents here in Big Time Wrestling on Coffee. Welcome everybody, along with Dragon Dave, Hank Renner Jr. We're in Salinas at the beautiful Police Athletic League Event Center here. A nice historic building. This is Big Time Wrestling, and that is Zach Mueller choking the life out of Andre Laveau with
not choking. I didn't see no choking. What do you mean choking?
No. You didn't see any choking, Dave.
I didn't see any of that either. I didn't see no choking at all.
Sometimes I could just scream.
You got to call it like it is. Call it like you see it. Come on.
I call it like it is because like it is how I see it, not how you see it, which like it isn't.
Oh, boy.
Oh, there we go. That's a front cradle now. And Andre Laveau is going to try and power out of it. Zach Mueller might end up with a backdrop here out of the ring if he's not careful. Andre Laveau coming back, a left and a right, but I don't know how effective those were. A shove off, and Zach Mueller misses that kick, stumbles a little bit, and Laveau hits him right in the kisser with a beautiful high elevation drop kick, but he can't capitalize on it, Dave.
But I am impressed, however, with Andre Laveau with his agility. For being a big man himself, you know, I mean, the agility of Andre Laveau is quite impressive.
Now we go, lefts and rights, trading punches in the ring, a block, another one by Andre Laveau. Andre Laveau's trying to get ahead of steam here, get some offense going because he was great in the early goings, but it's been all Zach Mueller until then.
Well, I got to tell you right now, Andre Laveau is looking to capitalize right here. He's on the offensive right now, and Andre Laveau, hold on a second, what do you got here?
Oh, beautiful double clothesline.
Wow.
Down goes Mueller. He's near the ropes, though. I don't know if a pin is going to happen. There we
go. What's he doing right now?
Well, he's moving him to the center of the ring, which is where you want to be.
He's setting him up.
Uh-oh, he might be going to that high rent district. Uh-oh, high risk maneuver coming up, folks. Way up high, Andre Laveau, Zach Mueller on the canvas.
Wait a minute.
Looking up, Dragon Dave's favorite
position to be. What do we got here?
Oh, way up high, Andre Laveau, beautiful.
Oh, no!
Oh, and he misses that swanton.
He wasted way too much time.
That is a rookie.
He wasted way too much time. Hold on a second, look at this.
Super kick right there. Laveau looks out cold. One, two,
and there it is.
Three, there it is. Andre Laveau pinned in the middle of the ring by Zach Mueller.
And your winner by pinfall, Zach Mueller.
Of booze for Zach Mueller. That took a big mistake by the rookie Andre Laveau, and Zach Mueller gets the Duke right here in Salinas.
Yes, you waited for the opportune moment to take advantage of that one moment where he had an opening, and he took it, and now he's the winner.
Plenty of action coming up right here. K1. Big Time Wrestling returns Saturday, May 20th, a super show. Newark Memorial High School. You'll see El Torito, Hornswoggle, Lucha Underground's Rey Fénix, Yoshi Tatsu, Katrina Lay, two-time WWE Women's Champ Victoria, and WWE Hall of Famer Tito Santana. Get tickets on btwrestling.com. Wow, Zach Mueller victorious once again against Andre Laveau. He seems to have his number.
I'm telling you, what did I tell you? Those Zen exercises are doing him good. What did I tell you?
I wish they'd do you some good.
Well, what did I tell you? I mean, they're working. He's on a winning streak.
He is.
And when you're on a winning streak, you don't disrupt anything.
You respect the streak when you're on a winning streak.
You keep it going. Whatever you've been doing, keep doing it. Whatever exercises you've been doing, Zach, keep doing them. Whatever you've been eating in the morning and the evening, do it. I'm telling you right now, you're on a winning streak. Keep it going.
Andre Laveau, we're going to see more of you. Zach Muir, congratulations, but we've got another match coming up. Great match coming up. The madman, the maniac, Clint Steele, takes on young JT Hollister.
JT Hollister, let me tell you something. You know, he and I have been on the gym, in the gym, and, you know, we've been exercising. So, you know, we're going to see a big change in JT Hollister.
Oh, boy. You let Dragon Dave near him. That's the end of that poor kid's career. Let's see it.
Way to the ring first, from Long Beach, California, weighing in at 153 pounds, please welcome JT Hollister. Making his way to the ring from Livingston, California, weighing in at 240 pounds, Clint Steele.
Get the sign.
He's got it, he got it.
Everybody, Hank Brenner Jr. along with Dragon Dave, big time wrestling right here on Coffee TV 20, sponsored by SharpshooterFunding.com. And what a contrast in physiques we have here. That's JT Hollister and the multicolor tights. He's slightly smaller than Clint Steele, and Clint Steele doesn't know what to do with Hollister's warm-up. He's got that beautiful warm-up rope there that he was using, and now Hollister's ready for him in the middle of the ring here. Dragon Dave.
Well, I thought for a moment that was a snake.
It starts out with an arm drag.
I was worried for JT Hollister.
JT Hollister, another arm drag. Down goes Clint Steele. Clint Steele charges. Hollister ducks out of the way. On a beautiful aerial attack, a drop kick, and down and out goes Clint Steele.
Wow, I gotta tell you, JT Hollister looks like he's pumped. He's ready. And he's giving away a lot of pounds to Clint Steele.
Over 100 pounds.
Well, I should say so. Not only that, but we have a new and improved Clint Steele, a more aggressive Clint Steele. So let's see how JT Hollister is going to contain
What was the other one? Old and obsolete?
No, he was. I'm going to tell him you said that.
Well,
you said it. You said it, not me.
Oh, look at this. Fair play has gone out the window here. Hollister tried to shake his hand. Steele will have nothing to do with it. There's a lockup, but I think, that's going to be dangerous for poor little Mr. Hollister. You don't want to go toe-to-toe with anybody of that size. And look at this. Now Steele is coming in, but I'll tell you, I've seen the big guy, little guy story many, many times, and it's the smaller guy who comes out on top after the big guy blows himself out, misses a move. You never know, Dragon Dave. Anybody could win here in big time wrestling.
Yeah.
Right here on Coffee TV 20.
I've heard a story like that once or twice. You know, it's called David and Goliath.
Right.
It's an old story.
And what happened? Well, yeah,
it's pretty old.
It's
an old story. Yeah, you know,
my mother was in that.
It's been around. Oh, well.
She's the one who baked the unleavened bread, you know.
Yeah, you know what? And I believe you.
You know, yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, it's been around. So, Mr. Steele elbowing and mashing poor little Hollister in the corner. Oh, Hollister goes in hard. But here we're talking about, there we go. That's the speed and quickness of a JT Hollister to get out of the way. A forearm finds its mark. Another one.
Oh, no.
Oh, he just plants him right in that corner. Oh, and gives it. Look at that. Look at he almost bent this poor kid in half.
Well, here's the problem. What JT Hollister needs to do is stick and move. Stick and move. Don't let Clint Steele catch you. Because if he gets you, he'll just put you in the corner and
tear
just pummel you.
You've
got to stick and move. Constantly keep moving.
This is his only hope. He's got to hit those ropes hard. Oh, and man, there's a back elbow right in the center of the ring, and down goes Hollister Steele now.
Yeah.
Here comes an arrogant cover. Arrogant cover. One, two, two count.
Well, if I was JT Hollister's manager, I'd be telling them to stick and move, and you know, but of course, you know, he's gonna find out the hard way.
If you were JT Hollister's manager, you would be in the locker room cowering. Oh, look at this, flying head scissors. Beautiful move by Hollister, and out goes Steele, very confused. Hollister really needs to capitalize on this.
What do we got here? Wait a minute. Oh, JT Hollister is posing. I don't know. I don't think this is the time to pose right now.
No, it's the time to get out of town.
No,
I'd be packing my bags if I were him.
Well, I'm telling you right now. I mean, JT Hollister, I mean, what he should be doing right now is, you know, hold on a second.
Here we go.
Fly and fly.
Flies right in. Holy Toledo. Unbelievable. JT Hollister. KOFY TV's Big Time Wrestling. Folks, come on out. You're going to see moves like that. That is the turning point in this match. That is what Hollister needed. That is what's going to happen. And I tell you what, Dave, he might just defeat Clint Steele here. All he's got to do is roll him in the ring.
That was a red eye.
That certainly was.
That was a red eye flight,
wow.
I'm telling you. Uh-oh.
Crowd helping out with the count.
I'm telling you right now.
He's got to get the other leg in and get him rolling in the ring.
What he needs is help to get him in the ring. I don't think JT can push Clint Steele in the ring.
Now, referee Ronnie Watson.
Look at him.
Allowing the time here for Clint Steele to get in.
I think JT needs to go to the gym a couple more times.
More times. There it is. One, two, Yeah, too much time there, Dragon Dave.
That would have been a Cinderella victory, in my opinion.
It would have been a Cinderella story.
Yes.
Shooting about a 9-iron on the fairway, right, Dave?
Yeah, but
there we go. Shades of Caddyshack. Here we go. Now a front face lock by JT Hollister. I tell you, though, I don't like getting Clint Steele to his feet because he does things like that. Just like that.
Well, he'll take advantage of the moment. He will definitely do that, you know?
Oh, he certainly does. And now, look, he's got all that weight. All that weight crushing down onto poor little JT Hollister. This is Clint Steele. He is a maniac, an absolute maniac. Oh, look how hard poor little Hollister goes in, way up high. Oh my God, body slam, center of the ring.
Well, I gotta tell you something. You know, Clint Steele is definitely using his weight to his advantage.
And an elbow drop finds the mark. That's 250 pounds down on the chest. One, two.
I had the pleasure of having Clint Steele on the Dragon Dave show. Thank you very much. And he said.
Did he eat the microphone?
No. What he told me was that whatever it takes, he will defeat his opponents. Whatever it takes.
I believe that. There's Hollister again.
And he's proven it right now.
He sure has. Hollister's going to have to write his name on that particular set of turnbuckles there. And Clint Steele with a knife-edge chop. That is doing insult to injury. He doesn't need to do that.
Well, why not?
Because he doesn't need to do it, Dragon Dave. All he's doing is adding pain to this poor kid.
Teach him who's boss.
There is a knee coming up by Hollister, feeble as it was, and now look at Hollister.
Oh!
Way up high.
What do we got here?
Oh, he's tried for that neck breaker.
No.
Oh, no. Steele has him.
Ow!
He is plummeted down.
Well,
there's another cover. One.
Good night.
Two, three. Good night.
There you go. Well, valiant effort on the part of JT Hollister.
And absolutely. Your winner by pinfall.
Some unsportsmanlike conduct here from Clint Steele. He didn't need to do that. He absolutely did.
This is Honky Tonk Man, greatest WWE Intercontinental Champion of all time. And I'm telling you, if you want to be a pro wrestler, if you want to get into the wrestling business, you want to be a valet, a ring girl, a referee, a TV announcer, the best place to do it is right here at Big Time Wrestling. BTW Wrestling is number one. It's professionally done. And you'll come out and be a great wrestler, valet, referee, ring announcer, anything you want to be, it happens here, BTW.
Time Wrestling returns Saturday, May 20th, a super show. Newark Memorial High School. You'll see El Torito, Hornswoggle, Lucha Underground's Rey Fénix, Yoshi Tatsu, Katrina Lay, two-time WWE Women's Champ Victoria, and WWE Hall of Famer Tito Santana. Get tickets on BTWrestling.com. That guy's a maniac. That's all I have to say. He absolutely destroyed poor young JT Hollister. But Hollister put up a heck of a fight.
Well, I mean, I got to tell you something. That's what you have to do here in BTW Wrestling. You have to just, you know, you have to get that, you know, get that killer instinct in you against any opponent. I'm telling you right now, whoever is going to face Clint Steele in the future better have that killer instinct in him. Because let me tell you something. Clint Steele has that killer instinct. He does have it. I mean, tell you right now. So he's going to be very dangerous down the road, you know, as he climbs the ladder in BTW Wrestling. So let me tell you something.
It's all about that, Dave, climbing that ladder to success, yeah, to that championship committee. They're going to look at that tape. But I'll tell you, killer instinct. You know, I have the instinct right now to kill you. I don't know what it is. I'm sure you folks out on TV land agree with me. After all these years, I don't know what it is, Dave. You just bring that out.
Anyways, for everybody in the locker room, you know, let me tell you something. Pay attention to this Clint Steele, you know, because when you face him in the ring, you better develop a killer instinct, because Clint Steele has it, and he is going to be very dangerous down the road.
Don't mention the word manager around him, please. Please.
I already did.
Oh, no.
We're in talks.
I knew. Oh, God. That's it. That's the end of poor Clint Steele. Speaking of the end, we're almost towards the end of our show here. We've got to tell you about next week. What a main event attraction we have. Tag team attraction. Go ahead, Dave.
I'm telling you right now, this Shane Cody and Devin Danger, they seem to be, forming a nice tag team.
Very good team, very polished team. They're on their way. We're going to look at them against maybe Classic Connection.
But they're going up against El Guerrero and Dylan Bostic. And don't forget Missy Carlisle.
I wish I could forget Missy Carlisle.
I'm telling you right now.
Oh.
He knows how to pick them, El Guerrero.
Sure does.
You.
They're coming up right here next week on KOFY TV's Big Time Wrestling. Hank Renner Jr., Dragon Dave. So long, everybody.